Several years ago, I made a video titled Our First Clownfish Babies, and it became quite a hit. In that video, we followed the first few weeks of life for these adorable little clownfish, and many of you were captivated by their journey. I received a lot of questions in the comments about both the babies and their parents. One question that came up repeatedly was how we managed to get the babies into their own little baby tank. This was indeed quite a challenge. Clownfish babies only hatch in the dark, very late at night, and the aquarium pumps would quickly consume them if we did not intervene. The babies are very weak swimmers and not capable of navigating anywhere by themselves. Fortunately, they do react to faint moonlight, which prompts them to swim upward, away from the reef, and into the open water. In the wild, they leave the reef to join the oceanic plankton, feeding on tinier plankton while being preyed upon by larger plankton. To successfully breed clownfish, it is necessary to simulate this environment. The setup needs to have no turbulence, very muted lighting, and a uniform, minimalistic environment. No corals, no other fish, and definitely no water pumps. The first challenge is determining the night they will hatch. This happens about a week after the eggs are laid, once they have lost their yellow color and developed shiny silver eyes. Our first step is to turn off the pumps. Using a small overhead flashlight to attract the babies toward the surface, we gently scoop them out one by one. Over the course of an hour, we were able to capture around 40 babies. We used a small 10-liter tank, covered on all sides by black plastic to block out the view and the light, and with a white foam lid to mute and diffuse the overhead lights during daylight hours. This setup simulates the feel of deeper water, far from the surface. Instead of a water pump, we used a small air pump set to the lower setting with a steady stream of gentle bubbles, creating very light water circulation.